नमस्ते बेटियों, खुश रहिए। आई जी बी एन मुस्कान कुमारी फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंड आई एम वर्किंग हियर एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी एंड द फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोलॉजी। सो टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द न्यू सेशंस विथ यू एंड इन दिस सेशन आई विल डिस्कस द बेसिक टॉपिक्स ऑफ योर एरर डिटेक्शन एंड करेक्शन मेथड्स इन द कंप्यूटर नेटवर्किंग, इजंट इट? So you well known that what is the data and what is the client, what architecture of the computer networks, how the data is transmitted from one place to another place or the source to the destinations, what are the protocols they are followed, what are the various topology they will use to transmitting the data. So what are the communication channels, what are the transmission channels, transmission media, these all topics you have well known. So this will be very easy to understand to you, these topics, what the error detection and correction methods. The error detection means what and the error correction means what and the, what are the various methods used to detect and correct the error data. So firstly, the first questions will arises in your mind that what is the error detection and what is the error corrections, isn't it? So if we talk about the error detection and corrections, then I will told you the error which is generated due to the transmissions to the destination from the source, they might be possible some distortions will occur in the communication channels through which the unwanted noise will be generated and that is attached with your data. So that is the error data, and this how this data is to be recognized, error to be recognized by the receivers, and how they recover that error-oriented data by resolving that error and get the recovered the original format of the data. So to make this all the process seem very easily, well, I'm just going to share the files which will help you to better understanding these ones. Okay. So you can see here that the error detection and correction. Firstly, you are going to detect the error, what kind of error, and how we will detect this ones. And then you are going to use the corrections. In corrections, you are using multiple techniques and methods to resolve that error. So what is the error? A condition when receiver's information doesn't match with the sender's informations during the transmission, digital signal suffers from the noise that can introduce the error in the binary bit traveling from sender to receiver. This means 0 bit may change to 1 or 1 bit may changes to the 0. So this is the basic we call the generations of the error. Now, error detecting codes implemented either at data link layer or the transport layer of the OSI model. Basically, the error detecting code which I using to check that is this data containing the error or not, then we will use any layer of the architecture of computer network, isn't it? In that architecture of computer network, we are using two layers. One is the data link layer and another is the transport layer. Now, whenever message is transmitted, it may get scrambled by noise and data may get corrupted. Okay, whenever message is transmitted over the communication channels, it may get there might be possibilities that it will get the scrambled by noise and data may get the corrupted. To avoid this, we use the error detecting code, which are additional data added, in which we are attaching the some additional data to the given digital masses to help us to detect if any error has occurred during the transmissions of the messages. Now, the basic approach used for error detection is the use of redundancy bit, where additional bits are added to facilitate detection of errors. Okay, So there are some popular techniques which is used to which is used for the detection of the error. Clear? So first is the single parity check or the simple parity check, two-dimensional parity check, check sum methods, and the CRC cyclic redundancy check. Okay. So what is the simple parity check? Block of data from the source are subjected to check bit or parity bit generated from where a parity bit of one is added to the block if it contains the odd numbers of ones, and zero is added or contains even the number of ones. Okay, this scheme makes the total number of ones even. That's why it is called the even parity checksum. So now we are seeing here that the simple parity checksum, it was how we are adding the additional bit to resolve and detect the error if error is occurred during the transmission in the message. So the additional bit will be what type? That will be the binary value, but there which value I should place as the additional bit, like 0 or 1. Okay, so there is some also techniques through which we will place the 0 or 1 and the additional bit, like the if the messages, the message, like suppose sender has this message, if the one we will add one in case only if the message block contains the odd number of ones. Okay, odd number of ones, suppose here is number of one is 3, so I will put here add one as a additional bit for detecting the and correcting the error. Clear? So and suppose if 0 will be added if the even number of 1, suppose it if the 1 is in even in this month, suppose there is also 1 at this place, then there will be 4 ones in this message block, so we will add here 0. Okay, so now see, this is the diagrams I am explaining. Here is the sender who is sending the data, and here the compute parity bits, and we are adding the one because this is in the odd bit. So transmission media, they are passing this message through the communication channels or the transmission media, and that message comes here and again compute the parity bit. If the this is going to be the even, even if it is even, then yes, or accepted data, or either it is not even, then rejected data. Clear? So this is the parity bit. Now if you talk about the two-dimensional parity checksum, bit are calculated for each row. Each row you are going to be calculated, and which is equivalent to the simple parity checksum, which follows the same formula of these ones. Okay, parity check bit are also calculated for all the columns and all the rows, and then both are sent along with the data at receiving end. These are compared with the parity bits calculated on the received data, like original data is this one, so you are replacing this data in the row format. Here are 4 blocks, so you are representing these 4 blocks as a what in the row format, and now you are checking here row by row and add the 0 or 1 as same as formula of the simple parity checksum. So the number of 1 is even, so you are placing 0, number of 1 is even, so you are placing 0, and now also calculating by the column wise. So number of 1 is odd, so placing 1, number of 1 odd, place 1, and number of 1 is even, then place 0. Okay, so this is the row parities and this is the column parities. Now what happens, you will write all the values like this one. Okay, this one you will write this value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is the 5 values. Okay, data to be sent to the sender side at with this package of the data. Now if you talk about the checksum, in checksum error detection scheme, the data is divided into the k segments of each m bits. In the sender send the segment are added using one complement algorithm to get the sum. The sum is complemented to get the checksum. Okay, the checksum is segmented is sent along with the data segments at the receiver end. All the received segments are added using one's complement arithmetic to get the sum, and sum is again complemented. If the result is zero, the received data is accepted, otherwise rejected. So here is this formula to check the error detected errors using the checksum methods. So this is your original data format. There are four segments here. So k equals to four segments, and m equals to 8. Total number of bits in this one segment of data is 8. Okay, so this is the sender, this is the receivers. What you are applying here, so using the two segments of the data and adding that ones. Okay, here you are going to be add, and the whatever the additional bit is coming here, then you are going to add against that ones in the here, and then you are going to take the result with this one, and then again add the third segments of the data bit with here to adding the this ones, you are get this result. Okay, and then add the last segment of the message block, then you are getting again the additional bit and add this one, this then sum equals to this one and checksum is this one. Now at the receiver side, what will happen? The receiver will get the what will be the at the receiver side. Suppose at the receiver side, this is the data which is taken by this one 100, 100, 001, 001 and 111. This ones, what will happen? They are similar as the receiver side. They are getting the additional bit. Then he is going to add this ones, and then they are adding the third bits, and then again this ones, and then again getting the additional bit. Then here is the additional bit, adding one, and we are getting this ones, this one. And again add what again add at lastly we will add the checksum we are going to add here, and then we are getting the resultant sum. So do the complements of this one. If the complement of the sum at the receiver side is all zero, then conclusion is what? Accepted of data, otherwise discarded that data. So you all will know about this one's checksum also. Now if you talk about the CRC, unlike the checksum schemes which is based on the addition, CRC is based on binary division. In CRC, sequence of redundant bits called the CRC check bits are appended to the end of the data unit, so that resulting data unit becomes exactly visible by the second and predetermined binary. So at the destination, the incoming data unit is divided by the same number. If at this step there is no reminder, the data unit is assumed to be correct or therefore accepted. A reminder indicates that the data unit has damaged in transit and therefore must be rejected. So here is the sender, receiver, data and number of bits, divisor, CRC and number of bits, data and CRC. Again comes to the receiver side, you are again using the data and CRC, divisor, reminder. And if the reminder comes zero, then accept the data, otherwise reject the data. You can see here, this is the original format of the data. So you are just going to be divide that data with sum here, and whenever you are going to dividing that data, then you will get last one is this one. So what you will add? You will add the remainder with this original of the data, isn't it? And you will get this data. Then what you will again dividing the message which is transmitted after coming the additions of this ones with the same divisor, and then you will get, if you get at lastly zero, all the zero means data is going to be accepted. If either here is once will come, then the data will be rejected. So this is all about your the error detection and the correction methods. So I hope that you will get these points very clearly. Okay, so there are basically how many deduction methods you have learned today. So firstly, you have understand about the errors, and in this you are using the four detection methods. First is the simple parity checksum, two-dimensional parity checksum, checksum, and cyclic redundancy check. Okay. So if you have any query regarding this session, then please let me know by drop your query into the comment section box, through which I will resolve your query in the next session. And please read these sessions through multiple standard books also, and the questions must be arises through this session, like the solve this questions via the CRC. What do you mean by the simple parity checksum? What is the two-dimensional parity checksum? Okay. So be prepared for these sessions, and also try prepare for the next sessions. Clear? And in the next session, I will discuss the data link layer protocols. Okay. Thank you.